And it is Water Cooler Wednesday.
That it is, and with us today, our very own Mark Hover Reed and Mike and Mandy from 104.5 The River. Guys, good to see you all.
Y'all good to be awesome.
Here. Thank you.
All right, well, we're going to start right off at the top of the news with the South Carolina lawmakers beginning the legislative process of removing a Confederate flag, as we just told you, from the state capitol grounds after last week's massacre at a historic black church in Charleston. Now, many see the flag as a symbol of racial oppression. Others say the flag's not the problem. It's a piece of history, and we shouldn't erase history. Mark Hover.
I'm one of those people who see it as oppression. It's a sign of hatred. I don't see it as a piece of history. We know what it is. And, you know, look, it's the flag of people who traded against our country and started a civil war here. So I don't see it in that way. I started my on-air career in TV in Savannah, Georgia, and South Carolina is just across the border. And I am just blown away that 15 years later, this is still a huge argument. They were discussing then taking that flag off the top of their state house. They did, and moved it to the state grounds. That was the compromise 15 years ago.
Lord.
A lot of it's a big tourist area, so a lot of conventions were pulling out because of this. So it's one of those things. I think it is certainly a step. And so I'm one of these people who says, yes, go ahead and remove it if they're going to do that. It is a step. But also I will say that that flag is also just a symbol. It really doesn't change the evil that a lot of people still feel.
So, Mandy, what about it? There are some people who also argue, though, conversely, that we can still learn from having those symbols right there in front of us. Is that the right approach to look at it, or should we just remove them altogether?
I think you can learn from a history book. I don't think you need to have that symbol flying above your state capitol. I don't think you need to have that symbol as part of your state flag. I think we need to get rid of it in all aspects.
Mike?
Yeah, hanging the flag as a piece of history is just an excuse. And that's all it is. It's a symbol of racism and oppression, and it should have been taken down 15 years ago. It should have been taken down 75 years ago or 100 years ago.
All right, guys, we'll keep it moving here. This month's 60 Minutes Vanity Fair poll is about corruption. People were asked if certain activities were acceptable or unacceptable. You can see their answers on the screen right now. So we're going to ask you for yours. First up, tipping a host or usher to get better tables or better seats. Mike, we'll start with you on this one.
Sure.
Sure. Okay. That was easy.
I would. I was almost embarrassed, but if I'll be honest, I would do it.
I have done it.
Right now, they're saying,
I like this honesty.
Wish we hadn't said we'd come today. Okay, what about paying someone to stand in line for you, Mark Hover?
No.
You don't have to, baby.
No.
You got your face.
Well, no. But I wouldn't.
I don't think that's right. You'll upset too many people behind you.
Yes.
Okay.
How much does it pay?
He'll take the job.
All right, here's one that probably a lot of people will agree on. Giving candy to a child to make that kid shut up.
Have you had a three-year-old? Yes.
Mike.
I've been to her house with her three-year-old. I say, whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
In a heartbeat.
In a heartbeat.
All right, how about using a paid sick day for recreational use? Mark Hover, go ahead and get on the hot seat right off the top.
No. No, you can't.
No, you can't. Your boss is watching.
Sure, why not?
All right. Forging a spouse's signature on documents in his or her absence.
No.
No?
No.
Absolutely not.
No. Not
no.
At all.
No. No. Okay. No.
Wait till y'all been married 30 years and you can't find them. I'm just kidding. Lastly, writing a letter of recommendation for someone you don't really know very well. Mike, let's start with you.
No.
No.
Mark Yes. Thomas?
Yes.
No, absolutely not.
Absolutely
not. Okay. Your reputation's at stake there, just as much as that person you're writing the letter for.
Now, baby, that's the truth.
Yeah.
Lord, I haven't thought about it that way.
I'm not vouching for you when I really can't vouch for you.
That's
no.
It.
However,
either one of you need me for a reference, I'm your man.
But we appreciate that, Mike. We'll definitely
But you'll also stand in line if we pay you.
Yes, that's right.
We'll keep it moving here, guys. A new book, Attractive, Unattractive Americans, examines how other countries view the United States. Some popular opinions. Americans, they say, are stressed out. We seem shallow, and we're inconsiderate to other cultures and countries. How would you describe Americans, Ms. Reed?
You know what? I don't know, but I will tell you this. I think that as Americans, we certainly think that we're on the ball and we're on top of it. And I spent some time in Italy, and you know this.
I know
and
that.
I told you, I was blown away of their negative opinion of us. They really did think we were shadow and really concerned with insignificant things. At the time, we were threatening a government shutdown. Mm. And their news just couldn't believe. They kept saying how stupid our lawmakers were to even let something like this happen. And that was the word they used in their news. So, yes, I think we're on the ball, yeah.
Wow.
Mandy.
I lived in Germany for 10 years, and that description adequately describes the way a lot of people think about Americans from outside of our country.
Wow.
All right, Mike, the last one is yours, man. Bring it home.
I got a feeling that I might be one of those self-centered, inconsiderate Americans who doesn't give a flip what a person from Germany or Italy feels.
I like it.
You shallow.
I'm a shallow, inconsiderate American.
I might agree with you on that, but I was surprised.
We think we're pretty cool.
Yes.
Yeah, we do. Mike, that could be your platform to run for office.
Don't give him ideas.
And win. One of those stupid lawmakers.
I don't give a flip. It's on a bumper sticker.